it's disheartening to come out here and see all this marine debris in this area that's otherwise so remote. Debris that's washing up from other countries.
This is not just a litter problem. Look at what's inside this albatross, a seabird. Found dead, plastics fill its body.
So little fat.
David Heirenbach and his team are researching the alarming rate of debris in the birds.
So here you see...
It is filled with plastic. Yeah.
This is the stomach of a two-month-old albatross.
Is that part of a drain?
Maybe. It's a brush. Look at that. You see?
About 80% of this baby bird's stomach is indigestible plastic, fed this by its parents, who confused it for food.
Morally, this is terrible. How is this possible, right? I mean, majestic, far-ranging, beautiful birds, right, in a pristine place of the North Pacific, and then you open them up, and this is, you know, what you find.
Heirenbach says every single bird he's opened up had some sort of plastic. Some large ones, like these toys and lighters and the adult birds.
So it goes way beyond the albatross.
It's also in our fish. NOAA Fisheries biologist Leslie Jantz is cutting into the stomach of a lancet fish. It may look scary, but this is what yellowfin and big-eye tuna eat. The tuna that ends up on your plate.
What is that black thing?
That is a plastic bag.
Like a grocery bag?
Or like just a garbage bag?
Nearly half of the lancet fish Jantz cut into had plastic.
And one thing that is a concern that we don't know is if any chemicals are absorbed into the tissue of the fish, which is a problem if it's going to be eaten by other fish that we consume.
A disaster still in the making, now widening its reach.
The environmental activists here in Hawaii say there's nothing they can do about the tsunami debris. All they can do is try to clean up the beaches. But they do say if they look around here, they notice a lot of bottle caps for disposable plastic bottles. There is something that they want the consumers to do and just use less plastic.